Today we are going to discuss an important type of integral. In which numerator is derivative of denominator. Numerator is derivative of denominator. To integrate such integrations, we shall put denominator is equal to t, means we shall put t is equal to f of x. Denominator is equal to t. The most important thing about indefinite integration is this, that whenever we put or we substitute anything, we need to differentiate at the same moment to both the sides. So we shall differentiate both the sides with respect to x. Again, I am repeating the same thing. Whenever we put or we substitute anything in indefinite integral or in definite integral, we need to differentiate at the same moment. So we differentiated both the sides with respect to x. Derivative of right side will be f dash x, which implies dt is equal to f dash x dx. On transferring this dx in right hand side, now you can see that f dash x dx, this f dash x dx, which is in the given integral f dash x dx, this f dash x dx can be replaced by dt. So instead of this f dash x dx, we shall write dt. And in denominator, you can see what we have. We have f of x. So this f of x is equal to t. So denominator f of x will be replaced by t. And now we assure that the whole integral has been converted into t only. Now there should be no x at all. It should be converted into t only. And as you know that integration of dx upon x is log of mod of x base e plus c. If you do not use modulus, no harm, no problem at all. So similarly, the integral of dt upon t, because we are integrating with respect to t, in the formula which I have written, it is integration with respect to x and the variable is x, but here the integration is with respect to t and variable is t. So its integration will be log of mod of t, whose base is e. Base should be written plus an integral constant c. So log of, now we can see the value of t. So value of t is from 1 f of x. So the integral will be log of mod of f of x with base e plus an integral constant c. So finally, at the last, we can say that integration of such kind of integrals where numerator is derivative of denominator, the answer will be log of mod of f of x base e plus c. But this cannot be used as a formula. This is like a trick where denominator should be substituted as t. But suppose if we are appearing or we are attempting an objective type of question or in an exam, where objective questions are there, then you can apply this result directly. Otherwise, you need to follow the procedure. Let's discuss some examples based on this. So the question is like this: 1 upon x log x log x. Suppose we wish to integrate this integral, 1 upon x log x log x. But in this question, it is not appearing that the numerator is derivative of denominator. So if we write this integral as 1 upon x log x upon log x. So the first question, can we write the given integral like this? Yes, of course, because a upon b upon c, you can see that numerator is complete. Why do I say that it is complete? Because numerator is having something in denominator, but denominator is having nothing in its denominator. So we can write one in denominator's denominator. So this we can write a into 1 upon b into c. So apply the same concept here. So on applying this concept, you will find that the given integral can be written like this. So it is now clear to us that derivative of log of x is 1 upon x log x. Even though we do not write like this, and let the integral should be x log x log x, it is not hard and fast rule to write like this star to the given integral. Let the integral remain as it is, but we need to identify who is derivative of what. So it is clear that derivative of log of x is 1 upon x log x. Let us see how. So I am substituting t is equal to denominator. You can see what is denominator. Whom I say denominator? Log of x. Not to all. The whole is in denominator. The whole term is in denominator. But I am saying that this is denominator. Means we are substituting t is equal to log of x, because numerator we are assuming that it is going to be like this. So dt by dx will be one upon log of x, and derivative of log of x is 1 upon x. Dx should be transferred on right hand side, so it becomes dx upon x log x. Now you can see that this dx upon x log x, dx upon x log x can be replaced by dt. So what, where is this dx upon x log x? Here you can see dx upon x log x. So dx upon x log x we shall replace by dt. So it is dt, and in denominator you can see that log of x is there. So log of x is what? So it is t from 1. Log of x is t, you can see. So now you can see that the whole integral has been converted into t only, and integral of 1 by t with respect to t will be log of t or mod of t base e plus c is equal to log of mod of log of x base e plus an integral constant c. So finally, this is the integral of this question. Similar integrals are there which you can attempt yourself. I am writing them. The very first integral on the basis of this integral, or on the basis of this concept, like 1 upon x log x. So I think it is very clear to you now that what should be substituted as t. So in this integral, you can see that log x should be substituted as t, and after substituting log x as t, The answer will be of this question is log of mod of log of x base e plus an integral constant c. Similar concept can be applied for this integral. Again, I am discussing one more integral, e to the power x plus 1 upon e to the power x plus x. Again, you can see that numerator is derivative of denominator. Then how should we proceed? We should proceed like this. T is equal to e to the power x plus x.